The iconic Washington Sycip is with us this morning. We don't have enough time, so you'll have to give me the truth about what you feel, okay? Because you've seen and met all of them and know all of them. Okay, first president. Okay, all right.
Marcos.
Yes. Yeah?
Very, very bright person. Very bright. He passed the bar exam without, finishing law school.
Yeah.
So my contact with him came when he first became president.
Okay.
He had an executive secretary, very bright person, Bang Salas.
Oh, yes, you said he would have been a good president.
And, Bang Salas was asked to solve the rice problem. And then he called me up and said that, I'd like to meet with you in connection with the rice problem. So I didn't know much about rice except planting rice, the song that you learned in school. So I brought Cesar Virata with me.
Okay.
He was head of our consulting division, and he always thought that he should work closely with Los Baños, the agricultural school. So I brought Cesar with me, and we talked to Marcos about the rice problem.
How did you find him?
Oh, he was very bright, of course.
Okay.
This is his first year.
First year.
But Bang Salas, of course, was the one that went down to the fields to talk to the rice cooperatives.
Okay.
And encourage them to grow more rice and so on.
All right, very quickly. Did you agree with martial law at any point?
Yes.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because at that time, we were not moving fast enough economically.
Okay.
And I can tell you some good things that came from martial law.
All right. Just name me one.
All right. Texas Instrument.
Okay.
The chairman I happen to know very well.
Uh-oh.
I told him to come here to consider an investment here.
Yeah.
All right. So he came here on a Friday. I had to cancel my golf game.
Okay.
And I'd never played golf since then. But I spent that weekend with him. He was convinced that politically, Philippines is okay. So he sent a team here. Then we worked, Cesar worked with them and suggested as to where to locate a plant.
Mm.
Then they, to our surprise, they didn't want the export zone, they wanted Baguio.
Okay.
All right, okay. Now you see the advantage of martial law.
Yeah.
So at that time, there's only one export zone and it's not Baguio. So I went to the ministry and said, look, you want this kind of industry. How can we get him when we don't have that export zone?
Yeah.
So they said, Wash, don't forget this is martial law. They drafted a decree, the president signed, Marcos signed it, and Texas Instrument was so impressed, they said, wow, how efficient you are. But that plant in Baguio is exporting $3 billion a year up to now.
Up to now.
Then they wanted a second plant. China wanted the second plant. But they were so happy about the workforce that they
had. Okay.
That even with that earthquake, interruption was one day.
Okay. All right. Sir, I don't mean to interrupt you, but we don't have enough time. Next photo. Next photo. Okay, of course we have. Okay, Cory.
Cory, of course. Well, she said that she was not qualified to be president because she was studying literature in school. In fact, I had one of her textbooks given to me by someone who bought it secondhand.
How would you describe her as a leader?
She was a very honest person, very dedicated to the country, but sometimes in the choice of people, since she was away for so long, she did not choose the best people.
Okay. Did she choose corrupt people?
Well, I would say people who did corruption.
Yeah. Okay.
But she did fire them.
She did. Okay. Yeah. All right. Next, after Cory, FDR, quickly. You were with all these presidents. Okay.
Well, he was a West Pointer, had good people in his cabinet.
Did you like him?
Up to now, I still see him.
Okay.
He had Roy Navarro. Mm-mm. He had Bobby Ocampo. He had this lady who was in charge of the telephone system.
Yeah, but were the FBR years one of our best years? Is that true?
Relative to the technocracy, yes. But I'm not sure about the military.
Okay, all right, next. Next, first we have that. We skipped ERAP. What about ERAP later on? Okay, GMA.
She's very bright.
Okay.
Very bright girl.
But that's 9 years of leadership. Were you impressed?
But at the beginning, you have to see, she appointed the technocrats who resigned at the higher 10.
Yeah.
And after that, I don't think it was right for them to collectively resign. Because then you force her to get people who are people that are closer to her.
Yeah.
Rather than technocrats who may have an independent mind.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure that the higher 10 resignation was the best.
Now, how would you describe corruption during GMA's time? You were in the center of business. Was it as bad as people believed it to be?
Well, I'm not sure what people believe it to be. No, but I guess on corruption issue, without doubt, it was a very important issue. And they believe, I think, and people believe quite correctly that mm-hmm. there was quite a bit of corruption.
Okay. Did you experience any form of corruption during GMA's time?
Personally, no. I mean, I did not, I'm not involved in getting government contracts or what, no.
But you know people who have?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the smuggling issue became worse and worse. No?
Okay. All right. Next. Okay. I wanted to ask you. Okay. Our Pinoy.
I'm very happy you have his picture there because he has a
very... He looks good there, actually.
Very transparent government.
Okay.
The only person who can say with a straight face that I'm not giving a favor to somebody who has helped me in my election.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So at that point...
Have you ever contributed to any candidate who ran for president?
Financially, no.
Yes, never. Honestly, never.
Never. Never.
Really?
And it's a criminal. It's criminal because I still have my American citizenship from service during the war. So that would have been a criminal offense.
So just for the record, even if you were awarded the highest honors in Philippine government, you still carry an American passport.
Yes.
They have not given you a Filipino passport?
Well, they haven't, no. But they've given me the highest honors of the Philippine government.
But you carry a U.S. passport all over.
But they all say that my heart is in the Philippines.
That's what I was going to say.